After your initial consultation with the radiation oncologist, where it has been decided that you will have radiation therapy, you'll be given an appointment for CT simulation. Your CT simulation appointment starts with checking in at reception with the patient flow coordinator.
When I arrived at the reception area for the CT scan, I just presented my blue hospital card. They advised me that they would be taking a picture, and then they just advised me to go and sit down in the waiting room. There were some forms that I had to fill out.
The forms that you fill out ask for travel arrangements and your preferred appointment times for your radiation treatment, so we can do our best in booking your appointments. Even though we give you a schedule, you can always ask a radiation therapist if they can adjust the times. Efforts will be made to accommodate your time preference window. But it's not always possible due to the medical needs of other patients and the requirements of the treatment unit where you will be treated.
I found the whole appointment process actually very accommodating.
The CT simulation is used to gather information about your body shape, the location of the cancer, and your healthy organs.
That CT scan that you've had will be used to plan your treatment with your radiation oncologist. Most patients who come in for their CT simulation have concerns and questions, and they're afraid because it's the first step of the process. A regular question that patients ask is, I've had 5 CT scans this week, why do I have to have another one? And this CT scan is a little bit different. It's not a diagnostic scan. It's used to plan your radiation treatments. A radiation oncologist or a nurse or a therapist will let you know ahead of time what the preparation is that is needed for the scan.
You'll be positioned by the radiation therapists during the CT scan. That position will be the same position that you will be in during every treatment. Immobilization devices are often used to help ensure a position that is relatively comfortable and will keep you from moving during treatment.
We are very precise in radiation therapy. We work in a matter of millimeters, so we want to make sure that you're kept as still as possible during the treatments.
Some examples of immobilization devices are masks, headrests, armrests, and beanbag cradles. A number of marks may be drawn on your skin with a marker. These are part of the planning process and also help in determining the best possible position for treatment.
If you are unable to maintain that position for 15 to 20 minutes every day for treatment, it's very important you let us know, because we want to make sure we're able to do that. And the CT sim is when we're best able to decide that. We will tell you what we're doing every step of the way, and we will let you know. During the CT sim, if there's anything you're unsure about, you can ask.
You don't feel anything at all. It's not scary. You're just laying there, comfortable, relaxed.
The images taken during the scan help us plan the position of your body during treatment and how we can ensure that you will be in the exact same position every time. Depending on the area that is being treated, you may have to receive positioning tattoos that are applied using a very small needle. These tattoos are used as a guide for the radiation therapists, so we can line up the radiation beam to the exact area that we want to treat every single time. The tattoos are used to ensure proper position, but do not necessarily represent where the radiation will be directed. These tattoos are permanent, but the other, larger marks made with a marker during the CT simulation process will wash off.
The application of the tattoos I did not find particularly painful.
It's similar to having a ballpoint pen pressed about your skin very lightly.
It's a very small scratch just underneath the first few layers of skin, and it feels like a very small mosquito bite.
Once you've done the CT simulation, we will contact you to set up your first radiation treatment appointment.
So once the scan is done, you will get a phone call from our booking office, and they will let you know when your treatments are to start. Another radiation therapist, a planner, will work very closely with the radiation oncologist to devise a plan that is best suited for you. So it goes through a whole bunch of quality checks before it's delivered to the treatment unit for you.